One hot and sultry summer's day, July of 64, to Cobden Village came two men who were not seen before. They hung around about that town and made some local days. They seemed a carefree, happy pair, two strangers from the States. 4 days went by that hot July, their dispositions changed. They entered Cobden's only bank for a robbery they'd arranged. They made a dash and grabbed some cash, an employee shot down. Kidnapping Jeannie Miller there, they turned and fled the town. Their speeding car did not go far, 'twas smashed beyond repair. They made a wrong turn down a lane and met a dead end there. They fled the car, hid in a barn, discussed poor Jeannie's fate, and planned to steal a farmer's car, two strangers from the States. At eventide, they broke inside a nearby farmhouse home. They held the family at gunpoint and warned them not to phone. With Jeannie Miller's life at stake, the family did agree. And then the gunmen took their car, with Jeannie they did flee. They headed for Algonquin Park when day had turned to night. Across the side roads, country lanes, just keeping out of sight. The biggest man, he had a plan, the small one was in terror. And Jeannie wondered all the while, what would they do with her? Meanwhile, the speeding car was spotted by the OPP. And at Algonquin's western gate, they waited patiently. A lone policeman stopped the car, looked at the license plates, and then he pulled his gun on those two strangers from the States. The two surrendered quietly, surrounded as they were, and Jeannie Miller told police about her night of terror. They said, we'll take you to your home where all your family waits. But Pembroke Jail is waiting for two strangers from the States. And now the story has been told, I'd like to say a word about a young girl's bravery, brave as I ever heard. Hats off to Jeannie Miller, folks, her courage highly rates. While in the pen are two gunmen, two strangers from